Hi everybody, this is another video response to another individual. This individual had informed me that he's a legit and authentic ninjutsu practitioner, and he holds a certain dan. And you insulted me by saying that ninjas didn't have shurikens, and that it was probably invented after the 18th, 19th century. As a matter of fact, you said you'll even give me up to the 16th century, right? And of course, that's very generous of you. But allow me to inform you about our system and the way it was taught to me. In our system, we were taught about Pyeongchang-sur and Shurikenjutsu. Pyeongchang-sur, for Koreans, it's throwing arrowheads and spear tips. And Shurikenjutsu is a method where you're throwing sharp projectiles or hidden knives, okay? And this was a tradition or a method way, way before the 15th century. We have a method specifically taught through the kanjas or Korean ninjas, and this is called hwal sur. It means the method of the fox, okay? And this method we practiced for a long time. And shurikens or Koreans have been using sap or kunais for a very, very long time, and Koreans even know how to throw them. Japanese will say kitsune, alright? Means fox, and Koreans will also call it yol. And allow me to shed more light by telling you that I think your legitimate authentic school lacks information or knowledge, and you should do some research before you claim that ninjas didn't use shurikens and the origins of plated shurikens or hira shurikens. I can also get into that. And this is also taught in the kanja or ninja system that I belong to. And this is again, Shosen Lu. Now I also want to address the future so-called legitimate and authentic ninjutsu practitioners out there who are ignorant about the Korean culture and its influences to Japan. It's my sincere hope that you research everything before you come and insult me, because I don't appreciate it. And if you don't like hearing the truth or hearing about our system and the way it's taught to me, then you don't really have to watch and stay ignorant. That's fine with me, okay? I just don't need your insults. But through all of this, it's my hope that intelligent viewers and true researchers will not have an ego or a bias, but they'll actually research some of the things that I say and then come to your own intelligent conclusion. Now guys, remember, I'm not claiming that I'm special or I'm a grandmaster or anything like that. I've always told you, I only offer you what little that was taught to me. And that's the only objective I have for sharing this knowledge or information to you. Thank you. Now this is from my personal notes, but anyways, we'll go into the shuriken parts of it, okay? This is a sapkar or kunai gatas, okay? These are actually
what you're looking at, okay? These are long, you could also cut these off. And these are also foxes, okay? And these are throwing projectiles and hidden knives. That's actually for Pyeongchangju, and so is that. You take that off and cut it, and you have these tips. These are arrowheads, and these are blades. These are two-tip blades, and they have them like this as well. When you cut the blades sharp like this and create a triangular figure or sword chips, you can also make them like this. By putting the sword chips into a bamboo, this becomes the handle, this becomes the knife. You could also make them like this as well. And of course, arrow tips put inside bamboo. Okay, you embed it. Now these blades, when you multiply them or cross them over, there's a special way you grip. So you can throw one and the other back to back. Or you can tie them up or peg them together. And then you could take these type of blades and forge them together, and you would create shurikens. And this is actually something that's taught way before the 15th century. Okay? Koreans and monks, they actually knew how to forge iron and steel into making these plated or these designs that you can throw as weapons. And that's a side view of what a fox, something like that, would look like.
God bless you, and we'll see you guys next time.